Hello, my name is Dr. Kim Monachino, Director of the Office for Exceptional Children at the Ohio Department of Education. Ohio has been facing a growing shortage of teachers and related service providers, including educational audiologists, physical therapists, speech and language pathologists, occupational therapists, school psychologists, and school nurses. The Ohio Department of Education has been working with partners in higher education, educational service centers, local school districts, and professional organizations to improve the impact of this shortage. This video was developed to inform and educate school administrators, educators, professional organizations, institutes of higher education, potential students, and families on the required and unique roles that related service providers serve to meet the needs of students with and without disabilities. It is also targeted to attract related service providers who work in other settings to the critical role they could play in school-based settings so that students can be successful in school. Recently, the department convened the Related Services Personnel Workgroup to focus on improving the coordination of state, school, and provider efforts to address the related services needs of students with disabilities. Furthermore, the work group was charged to identify and evaluate causes and solutions for the shortage of related services personnel in the school setting, including evaluating the long-term sustainability of potential solutions. I'm pleased to share this informational video with you that highlights the critical role and responsibilities of Ohio's related service providers and students.
Hi, my name is Jessica Heffler, and I'm an educational audiologist for the Summit Educational Service Center in Northeast Ohio. I currently serve approximately 10 districts across the Summit, Medina, and Portage County areas. While in graduate school working towards my doctorate in audiology, I knew very quickly I wanted to work in education to ensure students with hearing loss and auditory processing deficits had access to appropriate instruction. Fortunately, I was able to complete the necessary coursework required by the Ohio Department of Education while enrolled at the University of Akron. In addition, I completed a clinical rotation through Akron Public Schools to not only fulfill my ODE licensure requirement, but also provide me insight on the core differences between clinical audiology and educational audiology. Though I knew quickly I wanted to be in education, it wasn't until I was immersed in the field that I realized just how valuable an educational audiologist role is. As educational audiologists, we are the school team member uniquely qualified to provide input on hearing and listening access in the classroom. Students with hearing loss and auditory processing deficits spend over 75% of their day listening to instruction, much of that in the presence of background noise. Our role is to assist districts in providing free and appropriate education as mapped out by IDEA and 504, ensuring access to curriculum with accommodations and/or hearing assistive technology. Each student with hearing loss is unique, requiring the educational audiologist to perform functional listening assessments, classroom observations of various learning environments, assess auditory communication and learning in order to determine how to provide appropriate access in each situation. As important as recommending specific accommodations and technology is, it is even more important to educate teachers, parents, and other members of the student's team on what the effects learning with hearing loss and auditory processing deficits will have. My job as an educational audiologist is to ensure the student's academic team and parents understand the impact that hearing and listening will have on the foundations of learning, such as speech, language, and literacy skills. For students with hearing and listening needs, having access to an educational audiologist can determine how successful they may be throughout their educational career. My goal is and will continue to be to allow students with hearing and listening needs the same access to instruction as their typical hearing peers. For more information on educational audiology and how you can make an impact, visit the Ohio Department of Education.
Hi, my name is Terry Dinkelaker. I am a physical therapist that has been practicing PT for 25 years. I currently work for Montgomery County Educational Service Center as a physical therapist in the schools. I have worked in multiple settings. My true passion is working with children and has been my focus over the past 25 years. My interest in physical therapy began as a child growing up with a sister with cerebral palsy. I often attended her outpatient physical therapy sessions at Cincinnati Children's Hospital and began to realize what a rewarding job this could be. Not only did I attend her PT sessions, but I was able to help my parents carry over PT activities to enhance her strength and mobility throughout the week. I was able to see firsthand the success and influence of what a difference a physical therapist can make on the development and function of a child, for me, my sister Lisa. Working in the schools, I can recall treating a student with a genetic disorder that could not sit up without physical assistance, let alone walk, when she began services as a preschooler. By the time I left the district, she was in third grade and walking without physical assistance or an assist device with her therapy dog. She was able to achieve this success in her functional ability and strength through the consistent teaching of therapeutic strategies by her therapists in the schools, myself included, and implementing these strategies into her day on a daily basis by her teacher and paraprofessionals. It was this collaboration that she was able to see the success that she did over the years and is what has made me proud to be a school-based physical therapist. It is not only this huge functional success that I just shared with you that pushes me to do what I do, but is the huge smiles and joy that the students I treat have in their eyes when I walk into their room to greet them. It is the hugs, the messages they write on dry erase boards, being told by students that they love you, and the excitement they have when they are working with you, and the request to see you again following week. This makes me know that I am in the right place, that I'm doing the right thing, and that I'm making a difference in the life of a child. This makes me appreciate the impact I have on my students to help them achieve their best. This makes me realize how much I love being a school-based PT.
Hello, my name is Rachel Wright Karam, and I'm a speech-language pathologist for Hamilton County Educational Service Center. Speech-language pathologists, or SLPs, work to prevent, assess, diagnose, and treat speech, language, social communication, cognitive communication, and swallowing disorders in children. In addition to evaluating, diagnosing, and treating speech, language, communication disorders, and swallowing disorders, SLPs provide training and education to families or caregivers, as well as other professionals. Speech language pathologists also provide counseling, consultative services, and work collaboratively with professionals from many other disciplines. As a speech language pathologist, I'm able to work in a hospital, a private setting, or a school-based setting. And I've chosen to work in the school setting, and I found it to be so rewarding because I'm able to do a variety of aspects. First and foremost, I'm able to offer unique perspective as an expert in communication development and disorders. I'm also able to facilitate students' access to the academic curriculum and their functional life skills by targeting the language processes of reading, writing, speaking, listening, and learning. I can use evidence and research-based intervention strategies throughout my work, as well as serve on intervention teams and multi-tiered system of support teams to collaborate in the development of intervention and accommodation plans for students. Throughout my time in the schools, I can also provide services for pre-K students through grade 12 and provide support within a diverse range of service delivery models, as I mentioned, response to intervention or including direct instruction and collaborative models. I can serve as a school-wide and or district consultant and resource for administrators, educators, parents, and students regarding communication disorders and language learning disabilities. I can also target a wide range of communication disorders, including speech sound disorders, language disorders, pragmatics, and voice and fluency disorders. I can also address communication disorders across all disability categories within the school setting. I'm able to support changing communication demands of the students as they transition throughout their school careers and eventually into the community. As an SLP in the schools, I've been given the wonderful opportunity to work with children across the age span to address a vast array of communication needs. The flexibility and novelty in this field is what stimulates my continuous passion for what I do. And I find this diversity each and every day, even within my specific school-based setting. Personally, I'm fortunate to conduct a variety of tasks, including serving surrounding districts in multilingual evaluation procedures, conducting professional development events, and directly serving students in local Head Start programs and early Head Start programs. Within one day, I can find myself encouraging communication from working with young babies in the home to supporting preschool-age children in the classroom. A critical role as speech-language pathologists is that we also have to have a passion to cultivate cultural competence. This is an area that I'm very passionate about. And cultivating cultural competence and education for culturally and linguistically diverse students. As a speech-language pathologist, I'm able to do this in a variety of ways, be it collaborating with teachers to targeting communication needs with students and their families to support them in both home or school contexts. I love that I'm continuously learning every day, and it's so enlightening to share a range of students' skill sets when we provide them with the opportunity to show us what they know. I can recall one language screening I was completing with a Russian-speaking student whom I did not speak his language. So the teacher and I worked with the Google Translate app, and we recorded his description in Russian as he was drawing his picture. And from this technology, we were then able to identify key vocabulary that coincided with his picture. And this just helped us have a complete representation of his communication skills that perhaps otherwise we wouldn't have seen or been aware of. And it is in these small moments that I know I can make an impact on children's communication and ultimately their identities. And that is what I find to be so unique about being a speech-language pathologist, is that I'm fortunate enough to share in that experience with them.
My name is Amy Nolan. I have been an occupational therapist, OT, for 17 years. I became an occupational therapist because I wanted a career that involved helping people. The OT profession offers many diverse opportunities to work with people and help them help themselves across their lifespan. I've worked in the school-based setting for the Cleveland Metropolitan School District for 13 years, and I love working with students. I provide individualized therapeutic interventions to help students improve their daily occupations, including playing, eating, learning, and self-care by addressing underlying issues such as fine motor skills, attention, social-emotional learning, self-regulation, and motor planning, to name a few. In college and in graduate school, occupational therapists study things like neurology, anatomy, physiology, kinesiology, as well as psychology and activity analysis to better understand the whole person. Occupational therapists look at what the students can do as well as what they want to do or what is motivating to them. Occupational therapists address underlying issues so that the students can be as independent as they can be inside and outside of school. Being an occupational therapist allows me to use my creativity as well as evidence-based practices to make positive differences in the lives of children, their families, as well as their communities. Occupational therapy services supports academics, behavior, and functional performance. The occupational therapy practitioner collaborates with parents, teachers, and administrators to create solutions taking into account the child, the activity, and the setting. Many people think OT is helping someone find a job. OT is actually helping a person with their jobs or daily occupations or tasks. It is helping a person learn the skills necessary to carry out daily tasks that they need to do to be able to manage their daily lives. Here at Riverside School, I collaborate with Mrs. Lasley, a 6th through 8th grade intervention specialist for children with multiple disabilities. Mrs. Lasley developed a life skills cooking program for her classroom. These students prepare meals for staff members every 2 weeks. Lasley's Diner is a true demonstration of the use of occupation in the school setting. The students are learning and strengthening so many skills that are needed to be functional members of society. These are skills that are addressed in occupational therapy. Cooking is a good way to include a variety of students in a task at each of their own levels and to work on a variety of academic and functional life skills. Learning to cook is an important task for students of all ages, but it becomes increasingly important as students get older and need to learn skills for living on their own or with support, as well as preparation for potential jobs or positions in the workforce. Cooking gives the opportunity for these students to work on reading skills, for reading recipes and instructions, listening skills, sequencing, nutrition, meal planning, math for measuring and adjusting recipes, learning the value of money, using a variety of kitchen tools, fine motor, gross motor, endurance, literacy, and so on. Cooking is also very motivating to students because they get to cook for others as well as for themselves, and they're active participants in determining what to cook. My role as an occupational therapist in this class is to adapt the required activities based on each student's abilities and needs and provide that just right challenge to maximize everyone's potential and participation, regardless of their disability. In this environment, I am helping students maximize their physical potential, social potential, functional potential, and educational potential. I truly enjoy being an occupational therapist. It is a great and rewarding job.
Hi, my name is Bradley Paramore, and I'm a school psychologist. I got into the field of school psychology because it offers the unique opportunity to apply principles of psychology with helping students and families. I've also had a passion for understanding behavior and why we do the things that we do. I love helping others, particularly children. As a school psychologist, I'm able to apply my understanding of behavioral principles, problem-solving skills, and a passion for helping others to find solutions for students struggling in the school environment. As a school psychologist, I love that I have the opportunity to have a career I feel truly makes a difference by intervening with children of all ages. I've also had the chance to advance student outcomes through things like academic achievement testing, mental and behavioral health testing, monitoring students' progress, and advocating for student motivation and engagement, promoting positive behavior as well as mental health by running social skills groups, anger management groups, assessing students' emotional and behavioral needs, and coordinating services with outside community-based partners. Strengthening family and school partnerships is another important aspect of being a school psychologist. I've done so by helping families understand a student's mental health and learning needs, assisting with navigating the special education process as well. An example of this is I once had a teacher report concerns about a student's grades and behavior declining over the course of the school year. I was able to set up a meeting with the family where we discovered that the parents were recently divorced and the student was struggling with the divorce. Through classroom observation, I was able to identify that the student was having trouble seeing materials in the classroom. Working with the team, we linked the student with mental health services to help address the divorce, as well as changed the student's seat in the classroom and got him glasses. The field of school psychology is a profession that I feel is rewarding because the work you do helping others. It is also a profession that is never boring because each day can truly offer something different.
My name is Heidi Shaw. I'm a licensed school nurse for Athens City School District in Athens, Ohio. I found my way into school nursing when I served as an AmeriCorps member in our district and worked alongside our sole school nurse for 3,000 students in 7 buildings. Her passion and drive was amazing. She taught me that being a school nurse was so much more than putting Band-Aids on. It was health education, it was navigating through limited resources, it was staff wellness. She inspired me, so much so that I went back to school to become a nurse with hopes of one day returning to Athens City Schools to take over for her during retirement. And that's exactly what we did. In Ohio, a registered nurse with a bachelor's degree can be a school nurse by attaining advanced nursing education to receive certification. There are multiple colleges and universities that offer this education in their nursing programs. I can't recommend this enough. You learn so much through these programs to help you in your practice. According to the Ohio Association of School Nurses, the school nurse is the key to student success. As a licensed school nurse, I am responsible for performing health screenings, such as vision screenings and immunization checks. I work with our school psychologists, administrators, and teachers to develop individualized education plans for students with chronic health conditions, along with developing and managing individualized health plans. I provide teachers and paraprofessionals with health education in a variety of topics, including first aid, CPR, and diabetes. I also give presentations to our students in topics such as hand washing, healthy diet and exercise, and hygiene. I run staff wellness programs that challenge our staff to ride their bikes, start a meditation practice, or do yoga. And I run taste tests with the nutrition committee to get our students to try new foods and give our food service suggestions on ways that they can include these. There is so much that goes into being a school nurse, so much more than you can put into a paragraph. Coming home each day, knowing that I have poured my heart into something I believed in, helping the students of Athens City Schools, is a feeling that I never forget. Knowing that I am helping keeps me motivated to keep doing the work that I am each day. It can be overwhelming when you sit back and look at the world around us thinking, how can we do anything that will really help? Finding a way that you can in your career is how. For me, it's being Heidi Shaw, school nurse. It's realizing that a lot of our students are struggling with food insecurity, so working with community partners to develop a food pantry. It's coordinating with our Children's Services school-based case manager to figure out a way to get a kid's glasses fixed when their family doesn't have the money to do it. It's doing the work that needs to be done. I'm lucky in my school district to be surrounded by people that want to help. I feel like I'm a part of a team that gets it. We see the bigger picture, and we are working together to help make our school community a better place for our students, our staff, and our families.